Hi everybody, this is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? I hope so. Welcome to another edition of Ask Mr. Duncan. I'm so glad you could join me once again. Each week I will pick out some of your email questions and hopefully answer them right here. So let's get on with our first question for today. What is the difference between by me and by myself? This question comes from Dario in Italy. I guess you are referring to something you have done or created. In this type of sentence, the meaning is very similar. By me means I did it, and by myself means I did it all alone, without any help. Both sentences refer to just you. This dress was designed by me. I designed this dress by myself. Of course, we can also say, this dress is my design. Remember also that by myself means I'm alone. Thanks, Dario, for the question and for the beautiful photos of your hometown of Palermo. How do I speak English with confidence and speed? And who do I practice with? These questions were sent in by Fazia in Saudi Arabia, Hicham in Italy, and Tom from Laos in Southeast Asia. I have grouped these questions together as they are common ones. To speak any language, you need to feel comfortable doing it. To do anything confidently, you need to tell yourself that you can do it. Building confidence takes time. Try recording your voice and then listening to it. Get used to the sound of your own voice. Look at yourself in the mirror while speaking. Watch your mouth as you say the words. It may feel strange at first, but as you get used to doing it and seeing yourself using English, then your nervousness should, over time, fade away. To improve the speed of your speech, you need to have some sentences written down, which you must read out loud regularly. Start off by saying each word slowly. Then, each time you repeat the sentence, do it a little quicker, a little faster. See how many times you can repeat it before you have to stop. Practicing speaking fast is also a good way of building your confidence. Don't forget to have fun while doing it. Here is a great passage to practice with. Every day and every night, I speak out loud without a fright. My words are clear, my speech is strong. Now I hardly ever go wrong. The more I do, the more I know. My English skills will grow and grow. Write that sentence down and try to repeat it as fast as you can. So, you can practice English almost anywhere and at any time. It is up to you. Of course, a common problem is having no other person to practice with. Fortunately, thanks to the internet, we now have many opportunities to share our love of English with others. Social sites such as Facebook and Bebo, and live link software such as Skype, Windows Live, and Yahoo Messenger are allowing people to get together online and actually talk to each other. Many computer users are creating organized forums and interactive websites which allow people from different nations to express and share their love of the English language. How do I use ing? How do I use prepositions? When do I use phrasal verbs? These three questions come from Vinicius in Brazil. For today, I will answer one of those questions. ing, or the ing sound, comes at the end of words that define an action. For example, with verbs such as walk, talk, wave, and sit. He is walking. She is talking. They are waving. I am sitting. The action is happening at that moment. It is raining. Now it is snowing. ING also appears at the end of qualitative adjectives, such as amazing, interesting, exciting, and puzzling. As for phrasal verbs and prepositions, I will be taking a close look at how both of these are used in future lessons. So keep a lookout for those. Thank you very much, Vinicius, for your questions and the awesome video that you sent to me, which I will be featuring in my next full lesson. That is almost it from me for today. Before I go, I would like to say a special hello to Hussein in Turkey, Suntari in Thailand, Jose Rodriguez in Mexico, and finally, but not least of all, Mohammed and his younger brother Aboudi in Saudi Arabia. Hello to you all. Please keep sending in your emails with your questions. And of course, don't forget to give me your name and where you are watching me. That email address will be coming up very soon. This is Mr. Duncan in England saying thank you for asking me. And ta-ta for now. Mm.